Good morning, students. Already we worked out some problems based on identities. Today also we are going to work some problems related on identities. Now listen this question. Prove that tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 divided by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1 that is equal to, in your RHSI they are giving a proof, 1 plus sin theta divided by cos theta. Now see the functions. What are the functions given here? Tan secant. Here also tan secant. In your LHS side, select your LHS side. Tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 divided by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. So now we have an identity related to tan and secant. What is that? Secant square theta minus tan square theta equal to 1. So I want to eliminate this 1 in terms of secant and tan. Now listen, tan theta plus secant theta in your numerator minus this 1 is replaced in terms of secant square theta minus tan square theta, then divided by tan theta plus minus secant theta then plus 1. So I am eliminating this 1 in terms of secant square minus tan square. Now see, it is in the form of a square minus b square. Again we can apply tan theta plus secant theta minus, it can be simplified as secant theta plus tan theta, again secant theta minus tan theta, then whole divided by tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. So it is in the form of a squared minus b squared. It can be replaced as a plus b into a minus b. Now look out your numerator. Here also we are having tan theta plus secant theta. Here also we are having tan theta plus secant theta. These two factors are common. Therefore, we are able to take out the common factor tan theta plus secant theta. We are able to take out tan theta plus secant theta. Here also we are having tan theta plus secant theta. So take out the common factor. The remaining is here 1. Then minus, the remaining factor is secant theta minus tan theta, then the denominator is same only, tan theta minus secant theta plus 1. So in this step you are able to take out a common factor tan theta plus secant theta. Now listen, this negative is multiplication with inside, we can get tan theta plus secant theta in your outside factor. Now this negative is multiplying inside, we can get 1 minus secant theta, negative of negative becomes positive tan theta, then divided by tan theta positive, negative secant theta again plus 1. Now see the numerator denominator. This factor 1 minus secant plus 10. Here also 1 minus secant 10. Therefore, this numerator and this denominator will be eliminated. Now see the remaining tan theta plus secant theta. This tan theta can be written in the form of sine by cos, then plus secant. Reciprocal of cos, we can write 1 by cos. Now take this cos as the common, the remaining is sin theta plus 1. This is your RHS proof. This is your RHS proof. So take your LHS. In that LHS, 1 is replaced. In that LHS, 1 is replaced by the identity secant squared minus tan squared. Now some students may be asked, like this. Why sir? Instead of the numerator, we are able to replace. Denominator is also having 1. So we are able to replace or not. That is your question. Just wait. We can one more time. We can explain. Listen students. It is also the same question. But initially I am explaining. 1 is replaced by the related identities. Secant squared minus tan squared equal to 1. In the previous question, previous 14, I am replacing this 1. Instead of 1, I am putting secant squared minus tan squared equal to 1. I am replacing this 1. Maybe students may be asked like this. Why? For what reason we are removing this 1? Suppose I want to remove the denominator, whether it is possible. Maybe you have some doubt like that. It is also possible. Listen carefully. Tan theta plus secant theta minus 1. Keep this minus 1 as it is. But in your denominator, listen carefully. Tan theta minus secant theta, then plus. Now this 1, instead of this 1, okay, now we are removing the denominator 1. What is the related identities? Secant square theta minus tan square theta. In the previous work, we are discussing about removing the numerator. Now I am removing the denominator, secant square minus tan square. You may get doubt on like this. Tan theta plus secant theta minus 1. Now keep the numerator as it is. Now the denominator can be replaced. Tan theta minus secant theta. Listen. Now it is in the form of a squared minus b squared. We can replace secant theta minus tan theta. Again, secant theta plus tan theta. So the same step. But here you have to see carefully. This is the common factor, but see carefully, here tan theta minus secant theta, here secant theta minus tan theta. Therefore, we have to interchange this factor. See, your numerator tan theta, secant theta minus 1. In this, take out negative. Now the remaining secant theta minus tan theta. For what reason we are taking this negative? See this factor secant minus tan. So we need secant minus tan. So interchanging, we can get the negative. Then the remaining as usual, secant theta minus tan theta. Then secant theta plus tan theta. So in this place only, many students may be having some doubt. See the factors carefully. Secant minus tan. Here also we need secant minus tan. Therefore, you are interchanging. Negative will come out. Now keep the numerator as it is. There will be no change. Tan theta plus secant theta minus 1 divided by. Now this is the common factor. Now I can take the common factor secant theta minus tan theta as the common factor. Secant theta minus tan theta as the common. What are the remaining things? If you are taking this factor, remaining minus 1, again plus secant, again plus tan. So we are taking this factor as the common. Secant theta minus tan theta. The remaining is here minus 1, then here plus secant theta, then plus tan theta. Now see the numerator and denominator. Tan positive, here also tan positive. Secant positive, here also secant positive. Then negative 1, negative 1. Now the numerator and the denominator will be eliminated. The remaining is 1 minus secant theta minus tan theta. Now we are going to convert this in terms of your proof. How it is possible? From your lower standard, that is your 10th standard, you are already worked out. If you are having a denominator like this model, a plus b or a minus b model, then multiply and divide by its conjugate. That means secant theta minus tan theta, 1 divided by secant theta minus tan theta. What is this conjugate? Secant theta plus tan theta divided by secant theta again plus tan theta. See your numerator now. One is multiplication with the numerator secant theta plus tan theta. See the denominator a plus b into a minus b formation. So we can write secant squared minus tan squared. The value is 1. Secant squared minus tan squared value is 1. So we are having the numerator secant theta can be converted in the form of 1 by cos. Tan theta can be converted in the form of sine by cos. Therefore, take cos as the common denominator, the remaining is 1 plus sine. This is your RHS proof. So, your gain, take the given in your LHS side, one is replaced by the related identities, that is the concept. Which one is replaced? That is your convenient. Either you may be replaced with the numerator or you may be replaced with the denominator. So one is replaced by the related identities. What is the meaning of related identities? What are the given factors? That tan and secant are given. Therefore, you are aim to replace the one with the help of the related identities secant squared minus tan squared. So applying either maybe numerator or maybe denominator. Then work out carefully. If you are taking a factor, common factor, see the symbols carefully. After that, you are able to verify this one. So you can prove the given question in two ways. Now listen, students, we are having one more proof by using the identities. Now select your LHS. Now sir, select your LHS. That means secant A minus cosecant A. See the factor, first factor given. Then again 1 plus tan A plus cot A. Select your LHS. In this, secant can be converted 1 by cos minus cosecant can be put in the form of 1 by sine. So convert into the basic formation. Again here 1. This tan can be put in the form of sine by cos. Then cot can be put in the form of cos A by sine A. Cos A by sine A. Now, in this first factors, cos A, see the denominator cos A here, sine A. Therefore, take LCM cos A, sine A. That means sine comes here. Then minus cos. Simplify the first factor with the help of the LCM. Take sin A and cos A as an LCM. In the same way, here also sin A and cos A is the LCM. Now first 1 multiplied with sin A cos A. Then plus second family cos will be removed. Sin A into sin becomes sin squared A. Then here, sin will be removed, cos into cos becomes cos squared A. So now, take the LCM for two factors. Now, see the denominator, sin A multiplication with sin A, we can get sin squared A. This cos A multiplication with cos, again we can get cos squared A. Now, see the numerator carefully, convert like this, sin A minus cos A, sin A minus cos A, first factor. In the second factor, rearrange like this, sin squared A plus cos squared A plus sin A cos A. Rearrange the second factor like this. What is the purpose of rearranging? See here, giving the name, it is in the form of A minus B. The first factor is in the form of A minus B. Sin A equals to B A, cos A equals to B B. See the second factor, sin squared means A squared, cos squared means B squared, plus sin A cos A, we can say A B. Now see this identity, algebraic identity. A minus b multiplication with a squared b squared plus ab. Therefore, it can be written in the form of a cube minus b cube. This is your algebraic identity. So a minus b multiplication with a squared plus b squared plus ab. It is in the form of a cube minus b cube. Therefore, the numerator can be replaced. The numerator can be replaced in the form of a cube minus b cube. So see your numerator. I can replace the numerator. A cube is replaced by sine cube a minus b cube is replaced by cos cube a. Now the denominator is sine squared a cos squared a. So here one important idea is it is in the form of an algebraic identity. A minus b is multiplication with a squared plus b squared plus ab. It can be put in the form of a cube minus b cube. Now this sine cube a divided by, I can convert the denominator like this, minus, then minus cos cube a divided by sine squared a cos squared a. Now listen, here cubic and sine squared will be eliminated. The remaining is sine a by cos squared a minus, here cubic and square will be eliminated. The remaining is cos a divided by sine squared a. Now again see this sine a by cos a into remaining one more cos a. This square can be split in the formation cos into again cos. Again this cos a numerator divided by sine squared can be replaced as sine a again one more sine a. Now see this one, sine by cos can be put in the form of tan a. The remaining 1 by cos put in the form of secant a minus cos by sine can be put in the form of cot a. The 1 by sine can be put in the form of cosecant a. This is your RHS proof. This is your RHS proof. So from your LHS, just to apply the related formulas, related reciprocals, what are the given things? First replace secant and cosecant, tan, then cot. All the fundamentals, you can use the fundamentals. Then take the LCM. After taking the LCM, very important place, use the identities, that is algebraic identities in your 10th syllabus. That is the one related identities, that means a minus b multiplication with a squared plus b squared plus ab. It can be replaced as a cube minus b cube. This is the only one logic we are using, that is in the form of a cube minus b cube. After that, split the denominator, then you are able to cancel. Then split this cos squared as cos a into cos a. Sine by cos can be written as tan. 1 by cos can be put in the form of secant. So try yourself, complete it. Listen students, today you have to practice problems. Do it yourself. Try even in your home. Then we can discuss later. Listen, I can give them few tips. After that you can develop it. See the given question number 1. 4m equal to this one. Now listen, this cot theta is multiplication with 1 plus sine. So just to multiply, you can get cot theta plus cot theta sine theta equal to 4m. That means cot theta plus this cot can be replaced as cos by sine. Cos by sine. Again one more sine you are having, equal to 4m. Therefore, this numerator sine and the denominator sine will be removed. Therefore, we can get m equal to divide this 4 cot theta plus cos theta divided by 4. This is the first result you are able to get from the given one. In the same way, similarly, the same way, See, only one symbol is changed. Cot theta is multiplication with 1 minus sin theta. Just multiply inside. We can get cot theta minus cot theta sin theta equal to 4n. Again, this cot can be replaced as cos by sin. Again, one more sin you are having. That is equal to 4n. Sin will be removed. Again, 4 getting down. That means divided by cot theta minus cos theta divided by 4. That is equal to n. So first, from the given, you are able to find out m and n. After that, see your proof. M squared minus n squared, the whole squared, is equal to mn. I am working out the LHS side. You are developing RHS side. Now listen. What is the given one? M squared minus n squared. From your LHS side, see m squared minus n squared. I am taking first m squared, the bracket value only, m squared minus n squared. It can be put in the form of a squared minus b squared. Therefore, I can write like this, m plus n and m minus n. This is the concept you are using here. M squared minus n squared can be put in the form of m plus n, again m minus n. See here, already you worked out m. Here also you worked out n. Therefore, add one time. That means adding these two, we can get 4 as a common. Listen carefully. Then cot plus cos, here cot minus cos, cos positive and cos negative will be removed. We can get 2 cos theta. We can get 2 cos theta from this m plus n. Very simple way. Just add m plus n. Adding means 4 is the common denominator. Just add the numerator. Cos negative, cos positive will be eliminated. We can get 2 cot theta here. Cos will be removed. The remaining is cot. Here also one cot. 2 cot theta divided by 4. In the same way, see 4 once again. Subtracting once again. The same 4. So subtract it means cot gets negative, cos gets positive. Therefore, here cot will be eliminated. Here one cos, negative of negative becomes cos. Again, 2 cos you can get. This is m squared minus n squared value. Now, this can be simplified. See here, 2, 4. Again, 1, 4 will be removed. The remaining is cot theta. Again, multiplication with the cos theta divided by 4. So, we are finding out m squared minus n squared. But in your LHS, we need the whole square. Therefore, m squared minus n squared, the whole squared is equal to cot squared theta, cos squared theta divided by 16. Say this is the first value, that is your LHS value. Try yourself, work out the RHS, you are able to compare the same result. In the same way, isn't the second question also, I can just give an explanation after the try yourself. See here. One more, I am going to work out the same way you try yourself. See here, a cube equal to cosecant theta. This cosecant theta can be put in the form of 1 by sin minus already you are having 1 sin. Then take sin as an LCM. That means 1 minus sin squared by sin. That means a cube equal to 1 minus sin squared can be converted as cos squared theta divided by sin theta. Cos squared theta divided by sin squared sin theta. But we need a, because a squared means we need first a. Then take cube root on both sides. That means a. If you are taking cube root, then we can get a cube from a cube to a. Here you can get take cube root means cos squared theta divided by sin theta whole power 1 by 3. That is the cube root. But we need a square. See here a square. Then squaring on both sides. A square equal to cos square theta divided by sin theta. Then squaring means we can get 2 by 3. We can get 2 by 3. This is take individual value. A square equal to if you are multiplying inside, we can get cos power 4 by 3 theta divided by, if you are multiplying here, we can get sin power 2 by 3 theta. This is the value of a square. In the same step, using your d cube family, you can get d square. After that, just substitute in your LHS of the proof, you can get 1. Once again, listen, a cube is the given. Take 1 by sin, already sin. Then LCM means 1 minus sin squared. This 1 minus sin squared can be converted as cos squared by sin. This is a cube. This is the value of a cube. Then from this we need a. Then take cube root. So a cube from, you are able to get a. In your RHS side, take cube root. Cube root is nothing but power 1 by 3. This 1 by 3, again we need a squared, means it becomes 2 by 3. Then multiplying inside, we can get cos 4 by 3 theta divided by sin 2 by 3 theta. In the same way, find out the value of b squared. After that, substitute in your LHS, you are able to get the RHS proof. Try yourself, work out these two problems.